Stay tuned for Patrick Ching's Painting in Paradise. Welcome to Painting in Paradise. Aloha, I'm Patrick Ching, and I'll be taking you on some exciting nature adventures to see some of Hawaii's most beautiful places and our favorite animals. Then we'll come into the studio and learn how to draw and paint them. In today's episode, we visit the Honu, Hawaii's beloved green sea turtle, and we're even going to learn how to draw the secret pattern of the sea turtle's back.
All the way back to where I started. A little zigzag, jagga jagga, right by the armpit part, and even an area where the sun bounces right off that turtle's head, right into your eye, and bing!
I used a bunch of different colors.
The turtle is coming onto the beach. I mean, this is the sand that is wet, and this is the sand that is dry.
Hawaiian oceans are so gorgeous. When painting the ocean, I like to paint what's underneath first and what's on top last. I go and paint the sand as it goes out to the deeper water, putting in the rocks if there's rocks. And then after that, when the painting's dried, come over with a glaze coat of oil and paint the reflections of the sky on top of that. The colors of a Hawaiian ocean move like a color wheel or a rainbow, starting with the shallow yellowish colors of the sand, turning greener, then bluer, and even purpler at the deepest part of the ocean. To learn more about painting Hawaii, or to enjoy some Hawaiian art, visit me, Patrick Ching, at Patrick Ching Art Gallery in the Princeville Center. We're here at this beautiful Hawaiian beach, hoping to see our favorite animal, the honu. I got a wonderful family here, and I'm gonna let them introduce themselves.
Aloha, I'm Eddie Abubo, and this is my wife.
Hi, I'm Sarah Abubo, and these are our grandchildren and their good friend.
I'm Star Abubo.
I'm Rush Abubo.
I'm Lily Abubo.
I'm Jacob Turner.
Sea turtles are among the most ancient creatures in the world. Most of the species you'll see in Hawaii are the green sea turtles known as honu. In old Hawaii, the sea turtle was a respected animal and also an important source of food, and only the ali'i or chiefs could eat turtle in those days. Later, it was common at family feasts or luau and eventually became an entree at many local restaurants. That's when the honu population went way down. In the 1970s, the honu became protected by law and it was no longer legal to hunt him. Soon after that, their numbers began to rise, and today they're coming up onto beaches where they haven't been for hundreds of years. This might seem strange to us who grew up in Hawaii, but what we're actually seeing are the turtles reverting back to their natural behavior. I, for one, am very happy to see turtles close up in the wild.
Growing up, turtles would not even come near us because they were afraid of being caught. they definitely would not come up onto the sand like we see them doing here.
When I go to the beach and I have a little place where I go and the turtles come up to me and they come around me and they kind of look at me as though they feel safe and I feel like I recognize them and they recognize me and they feel they're in a safe place, and that's a beautiful thing. It makes me very happy.
When I see sea turtles, they're swimming in the ocean.
When I see turtles, they're usually like kind of in like the shallows of the reef, like kind of like near the crevices and the caves.
When I see sea turtles, they're usually eating.
Sometimes I see them eating limu mostly.
My favorite part on the Honu is the tail.
My favorite part of the sea turtle is the shell.
My favorite part is the shell.
My favorite part of the turtle is the eyes, because they're very big and wide, kind of like glass.
I like the patterns too.
I like the front flippers because they're so big.
A turtle looks like, to me, is like a rock, kind of. That's what I picture it in my mind. But once you put like those flippers on, it's like a whole different animal.
You at home, grab your pencil and paper, because coming up next, I'll show you how to draw Honu. We'll even learn the super secret pattern of the sea turtle's back.
A challenge we have as artists is to create miles of distance on a flat surface. To create distance, I often use mountains. The farther away a mountain gets from us, the more sky color is in that mountain. That's because its air is full of tiny little moisture particles. And these little tiny drops of water, they're microscopic, but they reflect the color of the sky. So the farther away a mountain is, the more of this moist air is between us and the mountain. So by adding your whites, purples, and blues to your faraway mountains, you can create a lot of distance in your painting. As you're painting the faraway mountains, your color range gets really small, and you're using kind of bluish, purplish colors. But as things get closer to you, the brights get brighter, the darks get darker, and the things that are closest to us, they got the highest highlights and the darkest darks. To learn more about art and nature, come visit me at Patrick Ching Art Gallery in the Princeville Center.
I've painted a turtle before, and it was kind of bad because I never knew how to draw it.
I think I can do this.
I feel way confident.
I'm excited to be here.
I'm feeling nervous, but I think I can do this, and I'm really excited to try.
I hope I can do this. At least I know that I can improve my skills.
Now I'm going to show you how I draw Honu using a three-step drawing process of forming, outlining, and shading. In the forming stage, remember to press softly, okay? I'm going to use a pen. You can use a pencil. We're going to press softly. How are we going to press?
Softly.
All right. We'll start with a shape for the turtle shell, like a teardrop, you know, a circle with a point on it. That's how quick it can be. The reason we're pressing softly is because we don't want to be erasing. We can always press harder later. For the head, I'm just going to put a circle where I want the head to go. And for those big front flippers, I'm going to use a circle attached to a long, skinny oval, okay? So where I want his shoulder to be, I'll put a circle and a long, skinny oval like that, okay? Another circle and a long, skinny oval. So give your turtle a nice, big flipper so he can fly through the water, and he's gonna thank you for it, okay? Back flippers, they're kind of like a human hand. You can just make a circle where you want your back flipper to go. They're shaped much different than the front flippers, okay? They're kind of like rudders. Okay, now we're gonna go nice and big, okay? I like the way you guys are not erasing, because you don't need to erase because we're pressing softly. If you want a boy turtle, you're gonna give it a long tail, like a carrot. A female turtle's gonna have a short tail. So it can either be short or it can be long like that. And right now I just kind of formed up my sea turtle. Got the shell that big, the head over there, front flippers, back flippers. And now I'm ready to give it some details. This is when you can press harder with your pencil. I'll just use a bigger pen. Okay, and again, I'm gonna go around the shape of the shell, all the way back to where I started.
Meow.
because the shell is going to be the top part of that turtle. Nothing's going to go on top of it now. For the head, I'll give it a nice little pointed, like a beak, and a smile. Connect it to the body. Give it some nice big eyes. That's the maka, the Hawaiian name for eyes, maka. And a little ring around the eyes, especially on the top, you can make that white ring even bigger. You can even see a little bit of the other side eye, just like that, okay? Put his maka in, okay. Now let's go in, like that. You got the happiest turtle in the whole place. For the front flippers, I take these little shapes I made and kind of connect them together. Remember, they're just a guide for me. So I'm gonna go around the shape all the way to the point there, come back, a little zigzag, jaga jaga, right by the armpit part, okay? Following the shoulders all the way to the point, come back, a little jaga jaga, and I have my front flippers. Okay, and a little jaga jaga right there, okay? Okay, go right around there. Give the jaga jaga right by the armpit there. That's his folding skin. Back flippers, remember, they're like a human hand with big webbing in between. Okay, so you can give it 5 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and back to the shell. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and back to the shell. Don't get too hung up on how this comes out, okay? Just have a good time. Decide if you want a male or a female turtle. Give it a long tail or a short tail. I'm gonna have a male, so I'll give it a long tail. And now I'm ready for the super secret pattern of the sea turtle's back. Okay, this is the fun part. Remember I told you the sea turtle, it was made of material just like your fingernails? That's called keratin. Imagine your fingernails really thick. That's the material that's used to make the sea turtle's back and scales. So every section of the sea turtle's back is called a scute. And first I'm gonna determine where the marginal scutes or the outside scutes go. Just kind of make the shape of the turtle's shell within a shell. And these are where the marginal scutes are gonna go. Okay? Good, nice and smooth. The more confident you get, the faster you can go. Very good, everybody's done, terrific. The pattern of the sea turtle's back depends on a shape. A six-sided shape called a hexagon, right? And if we put one part of the hexagon facing the head, one part of the hexagon facing the tail, and on the sides, it's like the roof of a house. If you get one hexagon in the middle there, you're on your way, okay? Just add another hexagon in the back. And another one in the front. And you've got three hexagons in the middle of the turtle's back. Okay, let's put three hexagons touching each other, like that, sharing that line in between. And it don't matter, you just have a good time. From there, you just radiate lines to the edge of the turtle's shell. And give it some lines to divide the scutes on the margins or the marginal scutes. Those are fun. And there you have it, the super secret pattern of the sea turtle's back. All right, keep going. Yeah, take all the points and send lines out to the edge of the shells, okay? You can go ahead and give your turtle some scales too. They've got kind of big scales up front here on their flippers. A little less scales on the back here. Now, if you want to know some real details about turtles and their shell patterns, if you ever see a clean turtle, maybe at the aquariums they have young turtles, they're ready to release into the wild, their backs are really clean. You can actually see a little sunrise on each of their scutes, like a semicircle with the rays of a sun. So if you got to see a turtle that's really clean, that has a really clean shell, you might see a little sunrise in every scute pattern. That's for those of you who want to have a real detailed drawing of a sea turtle. Okay, so you can do like a little sunrise in every scute. Ta-da! So just go ahead and put your scales where you want. When we come back, it'll be a whole new world as we have a freestyle Honu painting party. Aloha, I'm Patrick Ching. If you want to become a really good painter and do it quickly, let me teach you with my Painting Nature DVD. This 2-DVD set contains my most important artistic insights and all the techniques I use to create my most intricate paintings. In the first DVD, you'll see how I do a fairly complex painting from start to finish. In the second DVD, you can sit in on one of my painting workshops. Beginners as well as professionals can benefit from these lessons. My Painting Nature DVD is the best investment I can think of for anyone who wants to dramatically increase their artistic skills or even become a professional.
It's just changed my life. I didn't know I loved to paint until I actually took my first class.
Patrick is such a wonderful teacher.
It's real fun, really. I advise anyone to do it just once in their life, right?
You're an amazing artist, even if you don't know it yet. I can't wait to help you bring out your best on canvas. You can get my Painting Nature DVD at Patrick Ching Art Gallery in the Princeville Center or online at patrickchingart.com. All right, you guys, let's paint up our Honu drawings.
Answers, I will wait for you, my friend.
When I'm doing a realistic painting of a sea turtle, I'm going to take a good look at the shell and see how the colors overlap each other, and also the shape of the skin. It's very leathery skin, they actually call it leather, and the scales. After I've painted the skin and the scales, I'm going to go over with light transparent layers called glazes. These are reflections of the sky, and even an area where the sun bounces right off that turtle's head, right into your eye, and
this is a great experience. I've enjoyed it. I never thought I could do a turtle, and this actually is a turtle.
A turtle is coming onto the beach. I mean, this is the sand that is wet, and this is the sand that is dry.
I made this kind of a, is this aqua green or a teal green, in order to contrast against the dark features of the turtle itself.
I decided to paint my turtle kind of closer to like the deeper waters, like down where the sand like unfolds, like kind of more thinner until it comes into the rocks. But what I like about my painting is the shells. They really give out like a bright like color, like a big boom to it.
I use a bunch of different colors.
I did not give my turtle a name.
So I decided to put like some little speckles on the flippers to make it look a little more detailed.
I had a lot of fun.
I am inspired. I'm motivated to go out and buy some brushes and buy some acrylics.
I wanted to stay in the car in the very beginning because I thought the kids are going to really do this and I don't have any experience, but I heard Patrick say there are no no's, it's only yes's, and I went with that and it's all positive and it's all good.
Thank you for watching Painting in Paradise. Join us next week as we learn how to draw and paint a Hawaiian monk seal. I'll leave you now with some photographs our friends sent in of their beautiful Honu paintings. We'd love to see pictures of you and your Honu paintings, so send them to patrick@paintinginparadise.tv. Aloha, I'm Patrick Ching. Thank you for joining us on Art in Paradise, the show that features Kauai's favorite artists. Today I'm in the art studio of Fanny Bilidu, and you're going to see why I love her work so much. So a lot of your work has some fun in it. A lot of them have chickens and roosters in it. When you started painting chickens, what happened?
There was a painting that just didn't do anything for me at all. So I thought, I'm just going to paint a couple chickens in an inner tube. It kind of made me laugh, and it made other people laugh too. They enjoyed it, and so I felt free to be able to do more.
All right, so more of these chicken paintings started coming to life, and what was the reaction?
People say, like in the galleries, when people are walking around the gallery, you can hear them laughing, and they know right away they're looking at the chickens because they can relate to them. They're right. Kind of humanistic, and
they're doing silly things. Noticed that about your paintings. The roosters are having a good time, the painter's having a good time, the public's having a good time. I think it's a win-win-win-win situation all around. When people visit Hawaii, they're sometimes a little bummed because they get woken up by roosters and chickens in the morning. Do you hear the roosters in the morning? Do they wake you up?
You know, you tune them out after a while. But you know, if you turn on the bathroom light at night, they think the sun's rising, and then it's like this wave that comes across Hawaii, and everybody gets woke up.
Yeah.
That's the way it is.
Well, if you're a visitor and you're getting bothered by the sounds of the roosters and chickens, don't worry, it'll go away in about 2 weeks.
20 years. The wiener dog is driving the bus, and then we have two hens that are hooting at the rooster who's got his surfboard, and he's very annoyed, of course. And then we've got a chicken hanging her toenails out the back, one practicing snorkeling on top.
Is one mooning?
Well, I think that's what people must think, but yeah. Actually she's laying an egg.
I see it? Oh, I see.
And then the other one's watching to see if it's gonna crack or if it's gonna roll.
I see you working with these different mediums. How do you decide when to use what, or how do you go from one medium to another?
Oh, I think that it's when I see other people's art that is really fantastic. I get very excited about it, and then I'll go ahead and do it myself. I have to play with it, I have to do it.
What happened here?
It's crackled medium. You put it on and it dries with cracks, and then you paint right on top of it.
You meant to do that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So we got shells, marbles, more shells.
Heart-shaped
sunrise
glass.
Shells, sunset shells. What's in here?
Those are glass. Just categorize them by the different colors of glass.
So that's like beach glass?
So many colors, yes.
Did you actually go to the beach and get them?
I did.
Or somebody did?
I did.
You did? Yeah. Oh, man. And what do you make, like, for instance, with the glass? What do you make with the glass?
Things like this piece of jewelry. It's
Oh, beautiful.
Glass made.
That's how good it can look.
Yeah. All the different colors.
All right.
And then sometimes more simple, just one piece. And then I do a little bit of pottery, too. So this is a piece of pottery.
Like that ceramic?
Yes. And then it's got resin and shells, and it's just the process of trying something new. It's very exciting.
Where do you find the time to get all this painting done?
I think when you're addicted to something, you find the time all the time. And it's like a regular job. People go 9 to 5 and work, and that's my work. My husband is also an extremely big help. He just cooks up a storm and does the dishes, and he's just wonderful. Most of my work, the originals and the giclées, are in Kauai for Life, Nepali Art and Coffee, Aloha Images, Kilohana Galleries, Halalea at Kaku'ula, and Waimea Plantation Cottages, Espresso in Paradise, and then there's prints in Elephant Walk, Island Soap, and Jungle Rain.
Thank you for joining us on Art in Paradise. I'm Patrick Ching, and if you want to see more of Fanabilidu's work, go down to galleries all throughout Kauai, and especially down in Hanalei at Kauai for Life Gallery.